a lot of these independent researchers have a lot of really valuable information to offer. And what they have is time. And I think that's one reason why Survival Society keeps people tied up so much, because whenever, like for me with my on my homestead, like I was at home all day today. Like I didn't have to go into you know, a 9-to-5 job or anything, so I had a lot of time to think. That's not what they want people to do, because when you have a lot of time to think and research, you know, you can begin to figure some of these things out. You realize that you can you know, understand and comprehend these things.
I'm sad whenever someone my age, and I'm 48 or younger, would promote the idea that the questions that we're asking, Shane, the research that we look into, and the show that we're making right now is dangerous. I think it's really important, because I'll go back to the quote that I mentioned, where it's very hard to explain something to someone and have them understand it if their salary depends upon them not understanding it. And the salary I'm going to point out right now is the emotional and mental salary of being connected to the people that you are already connected to. If your friends, your family members, your coworkers, your wife, your husband, etc., all of them, perhaps children even, if they strongly conclude a certain thing, such as viruses cause disease, it's been proven, end of story, no need to look at actual evidence to the contrary, then that means that you're going to actually have a desire to keep your connection with them. And if you start questioning that, you're actually going to, you know, unless you're really skillful with the way you communicate, you could actually break apart your connection with those people that you care about. So intuiting that automatically, there's many people that I know who would, seems like they would kind of rather die than ever verbalize that they could be wrong about that, because they could be wrong about germ theory or virus causing diseases. Because to do so would create a rift between themselves and someone that they really care about, or perhaps everyone that they really care about. And that's really important to understand right now. So I always try to add some note of patience and caring and empathy, as it does seem very likely that the ruling class who orchestrate this and other, I would say, psyops or psychological operations, they love the division that's going on right now. You can see the division and hate and vitriol on Facebook and social media platforms, Twitter for sure. And they're eating it up. They love having all of us at each other's throats and having people alienated from each other and not connected and not doing business with each other. And the opposite of that is to be patient, to obviously do the cost-benefit analysis of what does it cost to be friends with someone, to have a close connection with someone. And what does it also gain you by maintaining that connection? And if all it takes is sometimes not bringing up certain topics because the person happens to be very firm on their conclusions and they don't have that humility or curiosity to go further and look deeper, there's no flexibility to consider various different possibilities, and there's no courage to actually face off and say a strong statement like, I'm not really sure that viruses cause diseases because I've audited the evidence. Would you be willing to audit the evidence with me? And I'm willing to be wrong on this, by the way. That could actually be a division between people. So if it's the dividends that you get from connections with people are much, much bigger than this small issue of what exactly causes a certain types of disease, then maybe, you know, maybe this is not the topic to bring up with those people, though. Honestly, if you love actually having a connection with someone in which you can actually bring up any topic and you're not playing a game of Minesweeper, that game where you suddenly step on an explosive and you've your game is over because you stepped on a topic that was explosive to them. Well, I personally love to have my unpaid relationships not be a game of Minesweeper. I like to be able to talk about any topic in my unpaid life. In my paid life, with my paying clients, I understand that I maintain the connection to the point where I want to keep them as clients, and I keep the objectives in mind, which is getting the work done. In the case of holistic healthcare, they have specific objectives, and I find through diagnostic methods other problems that are going on, and I bring them to their attention to maybe consider and do various therapeutic actions to, you know, essentially cause balance happening. But then, you know, there's going to be people out there where they're just kind of firm on their conclusions. They don't have that type of humility for self-discovery. The whole schooling mechanism of obedience to a groupthink and conformity to that group and everything that they promote, and a type of philosophical apathy, that apathy where they don't really want to question the methodologies that they use to come to conclusions or how many different ways that they could have gotten it wrong over the years or decades. Yeah, that's the kind of thing that's out there. So just try to be patient and try not to cut off all relationships, while at the same time, be courageous on your own and find the courage to look into these topics.
Yes, yes. Well said, well said. And I guess the only comment I really have in response is harkens back to what you were talking about earlier, you know, podcasts like these being dangerous, you know, questioning these things, because people do their own research, they might, you know, make a mistake. Well, you know, I think it's especially in this day and age.